the way that we make 99% of the hydrogen in the world is we make it by reacting fossils with steam and producing the hydrogen that way and releasing the CO2 to the atmosphere. So if you take a joule of energy...
At an energy loss as well.
Yeah, if you take a joule of energy in the form of hydrogen, it's 1.4 times as emissive in CO2 emissions and methane emissions as the same joule that you would get from just burning the natural gas to begin with, unless you capture the carbon and store it. And if you make it from coal, it's even worse.
Wait a
minute. It's two to three times as emissive.
So from a climate standpoint, if we didn't care about money or economic growth or net energy, just from a climate standpoint, using hydrogen for a fuel generated from fossil fuels generates 1.4 times the emission impact as burning the original fossil fuel?
If you don't capture the CO2, yes, that's accurate.
If you don't capture it.
That's correct.
And
that
how much
accurate.
Of are that 99% of hydrogen that goes to ammonia, et cetera, is sequestered today?
A tiny fraction of a percent.
Hydrogen in our world economy is actually, our use of it is a greater deleterious impact on climate than the fossil fuels used to create it.
That's right. And it's a GHG emissions sector that's bigger than aviation. Just making hydrogen right now emits more CO2 than the aviation industry.
How can the entire climate community not be squawking and talking about this all the time? I didn't know that.
They're hoping that we're going to make hydrogen from renewable electricity. It's just hope. And in fact, I've been referring to this hope that's been, you know, using people's willing suspension of rational thought as a, you know, their hope as a way to shut off their rational minds. I've been referring to it as the drug hopium. I didn't come up with the idea of hopium, and people have been talking about hopium since the first time Obama ran for the presidency, at least, and maybe before that. But the whole idea here is that people not thinking clearly and rationally about things let their hope run away with them, and they say, well, you know, we could use vast quantities of electricity to make something that we can burn, and then we could use it in place of things that we burn right now. And wow, wouldn't that be a wonderful world to live in? But the devil's in the details.
I wonder if it's
not
hope.
Hiding.
I wonder if it's hope or fear. Because if given a choice, we either have to use less or we could create a lot more hydrogen. People are going to choose the hydrogen route, even if it's a nodding your head sort of naive way.
Or we could do it smarter. So, you know, the wrong way to ask the question is, we can't burn fossils anymore. What else do we burn? Right? Because the answer to that, you can hear Eric Idle from Monty Python saying more fossils in the background. You know, it's the wrong way to think about it. We shouldn't be looking at fuel substitution. That's just simple-minded. Instead, what we should be saying is, we can't burn fossils to do this thing anymore, move people around, keep our houses warm, et cetera, whatever it is, heat something up in industry. How else do we do it without making greenhouse gas emissions? That's the question we should be asking. And the answer to that question is almost never make hydrogen from electricity. Okay, and making hydrogen from natural gas and burying the CO2, the trouble with that is, the worse a job you do of it and get away with it, the more money you make. So back to your original question, which was about the colors of hydrogen. They're all the colors of euphemism, as I mentioned. They try to make this pretty spectrum, but the reality is 99% of hydrogen is blacker than black, and we don't have a word for that. What is that? Black hole black or something?
What is black hydrogen?
There's the thing. In this lexicon of colors, black hydrogen is used to refer to hydrogen that's made from coal, which is about a third of the hydrogen in the world. Okay. And then they call hydrogen that's made from natural gas, they call that gray hydrogen, even though it's 40% more emissive than just burning gas, and hence it's blacker than black.
And
if
is
gas
black
is black,
hydrogen also? Is black hydrogen also 40% or worse?
No, it's worse. It's worse still than just burning coal, because you're starting with pure carbon.
So gray hydrogen is pretty black, but not as black as black hydrogen.
That's right. Black. This is the trouble. We just don't have. It's like, you know, the Inuit have apparently many different descriptive words for types of snow, and we in English lack them because snow is snow to us. You know. We just don't have words for how black something can be if it's blacker than black. And
Okay, so black hydrogen, gray hydrogen, what is and blue hydrogen?
So blue hydrogen is kind of like, you know, when you put those pucks in your toilet or your urinal in order to make it look blue and sanitized. It's the notion that you can take, you know, gray hydrogen and bury the CO2 and it suddenly becomes blue, you know? So it's making hydrogen from natural gas and capturing and burying some of the CO2. That's what blue hydrogen is.
So it's gray hydrogen with an extra step.
Yeah. I call it bruise colored hydrogen because it's kind of black and blue. Because of course, in order to do carbon capture and storage, first of all, somebody needs to pay you to do carbon capture and storage because it consumes energy and it requires capital equipment that somebody's got to pay for. And the energy that you use to run the carbon capture equipment is often made by burning fossils without carbon capture. So it results in a bunch of emissions. And then on top of it, you have the methane leakage up front, which gets, well, first of all, you're taking methane in as a feed to make your hydrogen from, so part of that leaks, you know, a world average 1.5%, but if you're getting it from Russia, it might be 7% of the methane that's leaking from the well to your plant. And then when you use that energy, which you get from burning natural gas, there's methane leakage associated with that. So, you know, by the time you're done with that, there were a couple professors, Howarth and Jacobson, did a paper in 2022 called How Green is Blue Hydrogen? And they basically trashed the whole concept because they said, look, at realistic methane emission rates and using the 20-year time horizon for methane's global warming potential relative to CO2, this whole thing doesn't really even do anything. It generates as much CO2 as if you didn't bother. You know, as much effective CO2 or global warming potential as if you didn't bother. Even though you're capturing some of the CO2 and burying it, you're not doing a good enough job of it. And as a consequence, the emissions are increasing per joule or staying the same or only very modestly, in the best case, very modestly reduced. So that requires you to do different hydrogen production a different way to get the capture to improve. And that becomes very expensive. And you also have to take methane that comes with very low leakage. So that means you can only get methane from certain parts of the world.